Hi! Many owners of private water intakes face a problem of iron exceedances in water. Water with high iron content usually has an unsuitable color and leaves rust deposits on fittings, plumbing systems and household appliances. The acceptable standard is 2/10 mg iron per liter, but this value is often exceeded even several dozen times. How to deal with the problem? I am going to answer this question right now. Iron is one of the most common contaminants found in water from a private intake. Its presence manifests itself through changes in a color, turbidity, and sometimes also through a metallic taste and smell of water. Water with high iron content is virtually undrinkable, it leaves stains on laundry and rust-colored deposits in the bathroom. What is more, it often causes numerous breakdowns of appliances which come into contact with water. There are many ways to remove iron from water. Choosing the right one depends on many factors such as iron and manganese concentration, pH, smell, organic compounds, turbidity, or ammonium ion occurrence. You should always start with commissioning a water analysis and contact an expert after receiving the results to choose a suitable treatment method. There are two types of iron removal methods. The first type is based on the use of chemical substances such as salt and potassium permanganate, while the other one is based on pre-aeration. The first method consists in ion removal through ion exchange. This technology is also used in water softeners, but in the case of ion removal, a mixture of multifunctional media is used to remove various contaminants simultaneously. If the water doesn't contain a lot of iron and is not turbid, a properly prepared ion exchanger, for example Ecoperla Sanitower, can soften water and remove iron at the same time. In the case of ion exchange resins, regeneration is carried out using a brine solution. The second way to remove iron from water is to use media regenerated with potassium permanganate. In the case of waters with greater ion exceedance, we can use media such as green sand. Regeneration takes place on the strong oxidizing bed. However, in the case of breakdown or faulty regeneration, heavily contaminated purple water may run from the tap, posing a health risk. It is definitely a safer and more effective method of ion removal. The process is based on water pre-aeration without the use of any chemical regeneration substances. In this case, there are two types of devices. The first one is Ecoperla Sanitower. This ion removal filter is particularly recommended in the case of significant ion exceedances or a strong water odor. Before the system, you need to install an aeration injector or a compressor and a non-membrane hydrophore tank. The injector or the compressor aerates water, which then flows into the hydrophore, where initial ion oxidation occurs, then ion partially precipitates. Catalysis, which means acceleration of ion oxidation and filtration, takes place in the Ecoperla Sanitower itself. Precipitated iron in an insoluble form is retained on the bed and you get purified water. The other device does not require an injector or a non-membrane tank because there's a compressed air chamber inside the cylinder with a bed. This feature is used, among others, by Ecoperla Oxytower. In iron removal filters with compressed air chambers, the whole process is similar. What's different is that air is sucked in directly into the device, where water is aerated right before it gets to the bed, where catalytic oxidation and ion filtration occurs. Due to slightly lower water oxygenation, this type of ion removal filters will bring good results in the case of slightly smaller ion concentrations. In both methods, based on aeration, water backwash is enough to regenerate the medium. There is no need to use chemical additives. As you can see, the choice of optimal technology depends on many factors. Before selecting the appropriate ion removal system, consult experts from the water treatment industry and ask them about the possibilities that will suit your needs. That's all from me. As always, I invite you to subscribe to our channel and give us a thumb up. And if you have any further questions, don't hesitate to write at this email address. See you!